way of saying I shouldn't go because I don't have everything plotted out that's completely stupid.
You should go. They'd be lucky to have you.
You're okay with this?
Emma, this is not about me. It's not about my life. It's about your life.
Randall, it'll make things harder when you have my key. You're not having me to lean on. I could defer a year.
Yeah, I could defer. We'll be okay here. This is your call now. Your choice. You can do this. And I'll be supporting you the whole way through.
Next at 10, new news about the power of pot, what experts say about the real punch marijuana can pack, and if it's a hit anyone wants.
Combine the right things, and something amazing happens. That's our inspiration for Fancy Feast Medleys. Wild Salmon Primavera tastes amazing. Also in pâté, Fancy Feast Medleys.
Colbert's got Paul Giamatti and an appearance by Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez tonight.
No cover.
You've been authorized to eliminate Zaman.
No protection.
All right, boys, let's get to work.
And totally exposed.
You have enemy moving on your position.
We gotta move!
They're as good as dead.
New SEAL team, next Wednesday.
Communities are coming together trying to keep flood water away. Tonight, we'll show you the efforts in Rushville.
A new study links cannabis to psychosis, but what does it really mean?
The Jayhawks hit the practice court here in Salt Lake City. How they plan on beating the hot shooting Huskies as March Madness starts right here.
Are cards costing a Kansas City restaurant? Why one customer says not taking cash is a form of discrimination. KCTV 5 News at 10 starts now.
Live from the station that stands for you, this is KCTV 5 News at 10 p.m.
Many communities in northwest Missouri and northeast Kansas are watching floodwaters closely tonight, worried breaches could send even more water rushing into their cities.
The Missouri River in St. Joe has reached major flood stage, and it's only a matter of time now before that high water moves into Rushville and Sugar Lake. Our Emily Rittman has a closer look now at how people are preparing tonight.
Here along southwest Mud Lake, flooding has closed the road. Levees here can't take much more water.
So far, we're still holding, but we're just at the capacity of what the levees can hold back here. If we do hit that 31.4 crest, we'll probably see some overtopping. Hopefully, we can try to prevent breaches.
Possible breaches are on the minds of many who have survived flooding before.
And then the water just gushes in.
Man, that's what everybody fears. How long our levees will hold out.
Fellow farmers, some with land on the line, stacked sandbags along low-lying spots near levees.
There you go.
Two young sisters from Liberty, Missouri came with their mother to lend a hand in Rushville during their spring break.
So people's houses don't get washed away.
About four pillars back,
is our property line.
Thomas Blankenship hopes his home is on high enough ground to withstand any additional water possibly headed his way.
As soon as I feel that my family's in danger, I will get out. But right now I feel like it's not bad yet. It's getting close, but we're gonna tough it out as long as we can.
Lanny Frakes says the flood damage already done around the Midwest is devastating.
We think there has to be some changes made, probably congressionally, to how the river is operated, where flood control is once again the number one priority.
Volunteers here will continue sandbagging tomorrow morning. Reporting near Rushville, Emily Rittman, KCTV 5 News.
Floodwaters are finally starting to recede in Nebraska. This is a look at the Missouri River in Plattsmouth, just south of Omaha. There's still a lot of water there, but it's not covering the major highways. Some of them have been allowed to reopen after passing inspection. However, I-29 remains closed from St. Joseph to just north of Omaha. So if you're traveling that way, you'll face a major detour. Drivers will have to take I-35 to Des Moines, then jump on I-80 into Omaha. That's an extra 140 miles and 2 hours of travel time. Well, right now, the skies have cleared out, and we're in the process of drying things down. And here's one point, too. The wind is out of the west, and that westerly wind is dragging in some really dry air. There's also a bit of a breeze, which will help to dry our soils down, which is great news because the rains that come in on Saturday will likely be soaking into the soil. Not much goes to runoff on Saturday, but the rest of the weekend could prove different. KB Complete City Cam looking at those flags atop the Oriad Hotel. Areas of frost possible by morning. It's going to be a warm finish to the work week and then a rainy weekend. So with that rain in the forecast, it's a good thing we have a quiet Doppler radar now. A look ahead to when that rain starts this weekend and how much we'll see with brand new model data. Coming up, Ellen, in your StormTrack 5 forecast.
All right, thanks, Gary. The headlines could be alarming. A new study strengthening a connection between daily marijuana use and psychosis. New here at 10, Betsy Webster went beyond the headlines for the takeaway that you might otherwise miss.
Well, this is the actual journal article in the publication The Lancet. We brought it to a doctor, and he said the key thing you have to remember here is the word correlation or association. It's sort of like the classic chicken and egg situation. Sure, they're connected, but which came first? In other words, are people who are smoking weed having psychosis because of that, or are people with psychosis turning to weed?
This study, and no study so far, has been able to answer that causation, meaning A plus B equals C.
Dr. Stephen Thornton is the director of KU Health System's Poison Control Center. He says there are so many variables that could figure in that have yet to be controlled for in cannabinoid research.
Honestly, I think when it comes to the human brain, it's going to be something complex. It's not going to be something simple like, you know, this equals that. It's going to be this plus this plus this plus this plus a little bit of this will equal that.
For example, is there a genetic component like they have found with alcohol that impacts how the substance affects different people's brains?
But he says there is a broader takeaway from the study.
What we thought we knew 20, 30 years ago may not be applicable to what's going on today because the drug is changing.
Getting stronger, that is, and quantity did play a role in the study results as well. It found a link with daily use and a stronger link with daily use of potent pot, 10% THC or higher. But there was no connection between psychosis and less than weekly use.
I think it's prudent for people to, you know, continue to have open minds about what it is good for or and also what it problems it may cause and to continue to evaluate it in an objective way.
Betsy Webster, KCTV 5 News.